Welcome to Slobland Flicks. I'm your host, Kyle Garon. And on today's episode, I want to talk about probably my favorite time of the year, that first cool down in early fall. Typically, in my part of the world, it used to be early September to mid-September when we get into those water temperatures of about 65, 63, 61, you're definitely in the game, where we start to see a push of not only game fish, the bait, the entire food chain seems to push a little bit shallower when we get to those water temperatures. And the reason I like that is because not only do you have access to the shallow fish that are there all year, but also now you have access to the open water fish that are now starting to filter up into those shallower, using the shallower part of the structures. That said, it used to be, like I said, early to mid-September, but I've noticed in the last 8 to 10 years, just because of the warming trends, I seem to be into early, mid, even some years late October before I'm seeing these water temperatures. So just keep your eye on the temps and you know, keep your ear to the ground. And once you start getting into those lower 60s, like I said, it's game on. Now, part of the reason I really love this time of year is because I'm able to eliminate water a lot faster, given the conditions are right. Whereas normally I would approach a structure, I've talked about this before, I'll approach a structure on the deep side, almost in an open water around it, and work my way in until I'm right up on top, slowly winding in, and then finally fishing the tops. Whereas this time of year, if I'm presented with the right conditions, I just go straight to the top. You'll see in the video where a lot of times, like, the highest spot is almost less than a cast length from where my boat is positioned. And that allows you to eliminate a ton of time and just hit more and more and more spots throughout the day. Now, that said, as well, if after, you know, 8-10 spots, you're not seeing it happen, well, then it's time to drop off and then, you know, reevaluate where you're at. But in the video, you'll see our conditions are absolutely perfect. Other than that, I'd like to talk about a few baits that I like to use. Typically, I base it on cloud cover, which normally, also, that's a whole nother ball of wax, cloud cover versus water clarity. But where I'm at, you'll see in this video, I have perfect cloud cover and dirty water. So, I mean, I know the fish are going to be shallow. I got the right water temperatures, and these are the baits I like to use. I'll start with no chop or light chop. When I'm going right up on top, I like a stop and go. You'll see this actual bait is in that video. I don't know if they even make this color anymore. Like, this video's from like 2017, these fish. So I'm just going back in my little library I got to get rid of some of the old footage that is useful footage, so I may as well use it. So yeah, I like the stop and go. Just the fish are a little more weary, I guess, when they're in, you know, sometimes a foot of water. So the stop and go, when you have flat or calm or even a little bit of chop, those type of conditions. Bulldogs, obviously, you know, this color's unreal in stained water, clear water. You obviously want to make longer casts and maybe use not something with this orange head, maybe something more natural, like the back part of this body. Black's one of my favorite colors of all time. Black and white, you can't go wrong ever in any water clarity. And surprisingly, I know a lot of you do, maybe a lot of you don't, but in stained water, black is could be a game changer for you. So don't forget that. Now, on the other side of the spectrum, chop. And chop is when I usually like to use an inline bucktail like this. You'll see my buddy Josh catches an absolute giant in this video coming up on this exact color, but it was actually his homemade bait. I think it was the first fish that he caught on it, and it turns out to be a, I won't give it away, but it's a beauty. But this color, this is one that I made years ago. And I like, I've talked about it before, I like to put, you know, 1.5 ounce weights in the ass. I don't like to force baits out. If they don't cast far, I'm fishing big water. If you're fishing big water, you want to use heavy baits. Bottom line, like, you don't want to fight your baits. And then along those lines as well as your rod, I'm now using 10-foot rods. It just makes your life a lot easier. You can fish thoroughly for 8 to 10 hours, no problem, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6 days in a row without fatiguing. Another wicked bait, absolutely killer bait that I've been using the last 3 years now, I guess, is this detonator style. I mean, this is made by Mayhem. It's not the only multi-bladed, or I guess two different style blades on one bait lure out there, but this one to me is stands out because of this giant 13 blade. Big fish hate this blade. Like, between this and the double 13 in the last 3 years, between me and my buddies, we have caught some absolute whales on these. So if you're not throwing these double 13s, you should be. The only thing I will say is that Mayhem does make them a little light. I don't know if they're fishing smaller water with less wind, but, or they just don't want to cast as far. But the way I like to fish, especially in clearer water, you got to be bomb casting. So what I like to do, I was cutting them apart and then just putting 1.5 ounces in the ass, but then you're wasting a whole wire. But what we figured out is he puts these clear beads. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see this. Give me 1 second here. So there's one clear bead right there. It's just a spacer. So he has two of them, but on the ass one, I just take a pair of pliers and I smash it. And then I take a rubber core sinker. I think this is about 1 ounce. The biggest one you can fit in there, basically. You pull the rubber core out after you smash that spacer out and you just pinch it down. No wire change needed and this thing bombs. It's like night and day. You will get, it will obviously go a little bit deeper, but not that much deeper. Just reel a little faster. These fish are aggressive. They're there to feed. That temperature is telling them, you know, it's game on. Fall has kicked in. Let's go. Let's eat. So you don't have to worry about your speed at all at this time of year. Maybe with the rubber when you got calm conditions. That's the only side deal there, I would say. Another cool bucktail that I've been throwing the last couple of years. I mean, everyone uses spinner baits, mostly for in thick, heavy cover. But this one, this particular one's from BWB. Super heavy. And I've been using these with trebles, 2 7-odds in over rocks in like semi-thick cover. They come through pretty good. But the key to these is they come in like 2 to 3 feet deeper, which sometimes that's all it takes. If you're getting a lot of follows, and these fish aren't committing, try bringing your bait in a couple feet deeper, and that's where these really come into play. So other than that, all I can say is, another good bait that I like to use is, as you've probably seen on some older videos, is a topwater during these water temperatures. A lot of other people from Minnesota, a lot of guys talk about it. They work. Don't be afraid to have one, especially if you got 3 guys in a boat, don't be afraid to have one guy chucking a topwater. Like, it's, you'll be surprised for some days that's all they'll eat is a topwater. So, and those, again, not so much on the flat days, obviously not on the windiest days where I would 100% go towards a bucktail, but kind of your in-between days, I would say, is when your top waters are going to shine. So, and a lot, and if you got high sun, then, you know, low light periods, morning and evening. Other than that, there's not much to be said. Just like I said, eliminate water faster by just going straight to the tops of your structures. I would start on your best structures, and if you're seeing fish on them, then, you know, at least try 1 or 2 new spots every day. So yeah, in this video, you're gonna see me and my buddy Josh. he's been on a few other videos, but his personal best is on this one. And again, he gets it on a homemade bucktail. I think it's his first fish. And, you know, there's a few funny episodes in there. I hope you enjoy. I'm not sure Josh is going to enjoy them, but yeah, other than that, enjoy the video. And hopefully we see you again soon. It's tougher for me to make videos these days, but I'm going to try and get a few out here and there. Enjoy.
He does that shit all the time. But who knows? I just haven't seen him. You'd think he'd fucking see the guy somewhere. It's crazy how no one fishes anymore. Like October full moon and the fucking 50% of the lake is vacant. It's amazing. I love it. What the fuck are these fish doing once again? Oh, I know. Belly to the bottom. Look, 30 feet of water. Good hit, but I'm trying to. I hope I didn't pull the hook out of it. Don't worry about it. Get that thing. No. Get the net in the water. Fuck, it's gotta be big. It's pulling like a fucking hooter, buddy. Oh, I got her foul hooked again. Pulled the fucking hook out of her mouth. Put it in. Not bad. Well, take it to the back. I don't want it up. I don't want that. Where'd it go, bud? She fucking popped it. I must have pulled the hook out of her face again. Oh, I'm shaking. That was a wicked fight. Oh, shut the hell up. Six, anyway, I'd say. Around there. Oh, shaking. Oh, fucking, it was just like pop. Oh, hooks are out, nice. Mind getting a photo of this one. Where are we? Come on. Think it won't work from this far away? I don't want to drift over that high spot. Just pull us out a little bit if you can. Snoop Dogg in the fucking house. Broke back, Musky.
Nice. yeah, probably 46. Look at that. Looks just that good.
Let's get another.
Oh, that's so fun. I thought it was giant because that guy had it hooked to the side. Two in a row, foul hook.
Make sure that's
clipped. Yep. It wasn't clipped in the way. Shit those fuckers off. I'm so fucking paranoid. This one comes up to like 14. Well, I think one spot comes to 11. Go away. God, get there. Follow here one time, it was fucking ginormous.
and just put on the brakes, like was coming in at fucking. My drag's fucked. Oh, she's big. She's a big one. No, netter here, but my fucking, my drag wasn't set when I set the hook. Oh, fuck. Over here, buddy. Back hook. Get it? Get it in the water. No. Yes! Oh my god! Oh! Sorry, dude. I'm not as strong as I used to be. I can't even do a fucking water and push up. The more I fish, the fatter I fucking get. Oh! I'm happy right now. Okay. Jeez, might be 50 on the butt. I'm guessing. Not crazy that it's not a shot. I'll tell you that. Here we go. Down a little bit. Okay, move the phone. That's fine. Move the phone out of the way. Here we go. Josh, good luck today.
Right on.
Two whales in the morning. Or one whale and one other decent one. Fuck, why do they do that every fucking time? Fuck, pinch just 49 and like 7/8. Would have been a lot better for her if she didn't fucking do that at the end there. If I hung her, she would have gone 50. Oh, fuck, I hate when I get hooked like that. I mean, I like it until I gotta take them out. We'll be right back.
Jesus Christ.
Not at all?
Yeah. Okay. We should probably get her in. Josh with a fucking whale. 53 at least. Girth on it is stupid. For wear, really. Quite the baller around it. Bad fucking hook position, dude. But at least you got her. That's the whole point. Yeah, chase her. 54? Yes, dude. You know what the funny thing is? I never catch big fish here. I got a 53 here once.